Yaskawa.
You are watching the PLCopen Basics video tutorial series. This video shows how to load the class project onto the demo. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier, and for this tutorial, I'm assuming that you have successfully connected to the controller. So now we need to get the demo up and running. Let me give you a quick preview of what we'll do. You'll open the class project in MotionWorks IEC, and then use the hardware configuration to go online and save to the controller and servos. You need to do this because the controller is likely to have been altered by a previous user. I'll show you a little bit of the hardware configuration, and I also want to overview the project features. Also, you should be sure that you can run the project from your PC and to use the HMI POU in toggle Boolean mode as an I/O interface. After this setup, we'll be able to jump right into PLCopen Motion programming with very minimal Yaskawa-specific hardware details. But if you're trying to do this with your own hardware and you still need to set it up, I would like to refer you to our Quick Start video series. You'll need to be able to follow along with me. So there are three requirements. Number one, you need to have a controller connected, and I'm using the Sikamiya Link Manager remote connection, and I've connected it. Number two, you need to have the class project downloaded. I've got the MP2300S with MotionWorks IEC Pro 3, and that's the third requirement, is you do need to have our software, MotionWorks IEC Pro version 3. So the first step is you need to open up this project file that you downloaded. If you didn't download it, you can get that from the training schedule and find the class that you're in and look at the class description for the class that you're in. This isn't the class, but we'll have a link in this PLCopen class. So to open it, the best way is to open MotionWorks IEC and then go to Open Project, navigate to your download location, and then unzip it. I was asking you, do you want to unzip it to the same folder? In my case, I don't want to unzip it into the download folder. So you click No to select another folder. And you can navigate to the default directory, which is C, Users, Public, Public Documents, MotionWorks IEC 3, I'm in, and Projects. So we'll just stick with the default here and save it. And if it asks you about toolboxes, you can click No to All. Don't need to overwrite any toolboxes. And now the project is open. This should be very familiar to you if you've been through the IEC 631 Basics training. Now we need to get this project's hardware configuration onto the hardware of this demo. To do that, open up the hardware configuration and type in the connection IP address of your demo. If you don't remember that, you can go to your Link Manager console and see what you're connected to. 15.23 is mine. And then connect. And you may or may not get this configuration differences detected. If your project happens to have the exact same configuration as what's already on the controller, you won't see this. But it's very likely that you will see this, and so we want to use the project's offline configuration. So click on the left-hand side. And now, while we're still online, you need to save. You may be presented with this task dialog. You can just click OK. And so this is saving the configuration to the controller, which uses XML files, and it's also saving to the drive's parameters. Says the machine must be power cycled. You click OK. It's very easy to do that under the online menu. Just choose reboot controller. That's essentially the same as cycled power. So we'll click yes. And you can even look at that happening here in the video window. You'll see this is the ready light at the top left, and it turns off during the reboot, which takes about 30 seconds. So now I know the reboot is completed. I see the ready light here is on. And so we are done with the hardware configuration. But I would like to give you a very quick overview of what's going on in here. And more details are given in other e-learning modules. This project is very close to the default that you'd get with a default new project. And this is the MP2300 SIEC controller. And we have these two servo axes. We're calling the one on the left here the screw. So we'll be representing these as a ball screw or some type of linear motion and a rotary motion here on the right. And I've set up the units of them to be the same. We're 360 units per rotation. And then the same information is also on the rotary axis, except we have the load type as rotary with a machine cycle of 360, which allows the position to be modulated. We'll get more into that later. And we also have a virtual axis, which I've given similar units to. Now, if you're using the MP2600, then of course it has just one axis. Now back to the real axes. I've made only two changes from default. One of them is the I/O. I've set the over travel signals to off. So should somebody come by, then you won't be stuck and unable to move due to the limit switch over travel. I've also changed the absolute encoder to incremental mode, which means that the position will reset back to zero anytime you reboot the controller. And so that just simplifies that hardware feature for us to be able to focus on PLCopen programming. So that's about all that we need to look at right now for the hardware configuration. So you can close it. And now I'd like to give you a little tour of the project. This project is very close to the default given by the new project template. When you choose File, New Project, and choose the controller that you want, almost all of this will be given to you. And the first thing you might notice is that there are both firmware libraries for PLCopen Plus, which gives all of the PLCopen motion control commands, as well as a few additional Yaskawa motion commands. We have the Datatypes Toolbox, which is a library created by Yaskawa that has really no code, just all of the basic data types that we'll need for PLCopen. We have PLCopen Toolbox, that's another user library, which gives us a whole bunch of function blocks that give higher level functionality beyond PLCopen. And so we'll be showing you in this training course how to use some of these. Notice there are no project data types. And under logical POUs, each of these four are given as part of the template and they're all blank, except for this one called HMII. And so I'm going to double click to open it. And this is going to be the toggle Boolean interface so that since you can't come through and flip switches like you would if you were here in a live class, you'll be able to do the equivalent by clicking on these contacts. We'll have you try that here pretty soon. Yeah, you'll notice that there is a function block called YTTS toggle 1, and that I've put in this folder here called YTTS toggle. You can double click on it if you want to look at the code. All it does is just you click on the input and the output queue toggles from being on to off. So it will change this input from being momentary to toggle. And you'll see that the output to each of these rungs is a global variable. I've stuck with the G underscore prefix for all these global variables. And so you'll be able to use these global variables to trigger different PLCopen function blocks in the upcoming video tutorials. And so speaking of globals, that leads me to the global variables list. Let me start at the top here. Besides the system variables, you'll notice that there's a group of variables for each of the hardware pieces. The screw servo, the rotary servo, and the LI001, the I/O card. And so you'll see these are all populated automatically by that hardware configuration when we save. So any of these variables will be coming straight in or straight out to those devices. And then I have created some user variables, which are essentially just these globals used in the HMI underscore I POU, which I didn't mention before, it's running in the slow task. So with that little tour, let's make and download the project. This should be familiar to you. Click rebuild or make. And then in your project control, that IP address should be set up already, so you have communication. And you'll click download. Don't do download changes, because this is the first download. You'll probably want to include the boot project, so that if you ever reboot, you still have the project again. And then click download. And here's where you get an idea of the speed of your connection. It said warm start was not possible. There comes the boot project. If you have a fast connection, this will be really quick. And if your internet connection is slow, then that may take a little while. So now our controller has this project. So I'd like to show something here. I've uncovered the controller, and its ready light is on the top left, and then right next to it is the run light. I know you can't read it, but very similar to the PLC simulator that we used in MotionWorks IEC Basics. Here when we click cold start, you'll see that that run light turns on. And if you stop the PLC, then that run light turns off. So that's a good one to keep an eye on, because if this is off, then you know you're not running your resource, not running your controller. So keep that one running, and usually a warm start is enough. That cold start may be required if the memory was cleared or if you switch projects. And then we always recommend you close this resource to cut down on the network traffic. And I'll go back to full screen. And as you've done many times in the other class, you can turn on debug mode. And now you can interact with this. And to make this work the way it's intended, you will go to the online menu and turn on toggle Boolean values. You can click on these inputs, and that latches on the global variables, and we'll be writing code to take those variables to initiate motion and turn on the servo. This output does retain, so if you ever were to stop and warm start, it's not cleared. That's intentional. And so in the place of the switch panel, you'll be able to use this panel. Of course, right now this has no function. These are just variables turning on and off. So thank you for your attention, and I hope that you've been able to follow along and connect to the demo, connect to the controller, and run this class template project.